Thank you all so much for tuning into Town and Country. I am your host, Alicia Lewis. We are almost to the weekend, but not quite, because there is still so much to unpack here on Town and Country. But first things first, I needed a little pick-me-up, so I decided to do some coffee and conversation with travel agent Miss Holly Elrod. How are you today?
I'm good. How are you?
Awesome. I'm super excited because I need a vacation.
Yes.
All right, Miss Holly. So I want to be honest with you. I want to go to Jamaica. In Mexico.
Absolutely.
And Thailand and Paris.
Yeah.
And so many other places. But I want to go for $100. Is that possible?
No, it's not possible. But we can get you the best deal. Absolutely.
I'm just kidding. All right. So you're here to tell us some hacks and give us some travel tips. Yes. For this summer, for our summer traveling. So exactly what should we do when we're traveling? When we're booking our trip.
So when you're booking your trip, the best thing, obviously, is to work with a travel advisor. Okay. They know the best deals, they know the best dates, they know the best places to go, and they can really give you that insider scoop to what can get you the best bang for your buck for your trip. But the next thing to do, I would say, is to keep your dates flexible when you're planning your trip. Okay. Sometimes that's not possible, you know, if you have kids and you have to go for spring break. But if it's at all possible, keep it flexible, because you can get some really good deals on airfare and your resorts. You know, if you're not if you're traveling on like a Tuesday or a Wednesday, sometimes you can get, you know, $200 or $300 off your airfare and get a really great deal. So
wow.
That's one big tip I would definitely say.
So what would you say are some big travel misconceptions?
Yeah, so some things I often hear is that people think it's really expensive to travel internationally. Mm-hmm. So most of what I do is international travel. We do a lot of travel to the Caribbean, Mexico, like you mentioned, Jamaica. But we also do some things to Europe. And some people think, you know, oh, I can't afford that. But when we package everything together and we include your food and your transfers, it really sometimes can be not that much more to go on an all-inclusive vacation than it would be to go somewhere nearby like a beach in Florida or something like that.
Now, are you more of a resort girl or do you like hotels?
It's so hard. I like both. So
really?
I feel like when you're traveling, when you're going to the beach and you just want a relaxing vacation, so a lot of what I do are honeymoons, and I think an all-inclusive vacation is perfect for a honeymoon, because you've had the stress of the wedding and you've been just pent up and you just need to relax with your new spouse. So for a honeymoon, I say definitely go for an all-inclusive trip and then go on that big European vacation maybe a few years later down the road when you spent time together. But I do think hotels are great too when you're traveling, like, and you want to really experience the culture of the place you're traveling to.
What has been the most memorable experience you've had traveling, and where?
Yeah, I would say, so my husband and I went to Italy last year, and so we really enjoyed Tuscany, and that was one of my favorite places that I visited. But I'd also say one of my favorite trips was just kind of laying on the beach for our honeymoon. Mm-hmm. We got married over COVID, so we got married in March. And so we had to postpone our honeymoon to a year later. But just spending time together on the beach and just enjoying each other's company was probably one of my favorite memories from a trip in Jamaica.
So. That's awesome. So what inspired you to start your Honeymoon Inc. business?
Yes, I've always loved coordinating travel since I was little, and I just think it's so valuable to get out and see the world and see like all the creation that God has made. You really can't understand it until you experience and get out there, and so that's been one thing. I just want to make it accessible for everyone to see the beauty of the Lord's creation, and sometimes people feel overwhelmed by traveling internationally, and so to make it accessible where people can do this big trip and they don't feel overwhelmed, we coordinate the transfers and we just get you there, and all you have to do is arrive. So
awesome. So what can your clients expect when booking with you? Is there anything that they actually have to do, or do you kind of just go ahead and book everything? They just tell you where to go?
It's up to them. So some people really want to be hands-on and plan all the details of their trip, and they just want advice on what to do. But some people really want to just show up to the airport and travel and just have everything done for them. So we offer both options. If they want to be hands-on with coordinating their trip, they can. If they want us to take care of everything, they can do that too.
Gotcha. So. Okay. And so where can we learn more about Honeymoons?
Yeah.
And how can we book with Miss Holly? I'm booking with you.
Yeah.
I already told you that.
So you can find us at our website. So I have a personal website. It's called hdedestinations.com. Mm-hmm. We also have a website called honeymoonsinc.com. So you can find us there. You can also email me, Holly. It's Holly at honeymoonsinc.com. So you can reach me there, and you can reach me by the phone too.
Awesome. Well, Hallie, I can't go to my destination with just $100. But I did learn some good tips and some hacks. So thank you so much for that.
Yeah, absolutely.
Awesome. All right, you guys. So we're going to take a quick break. But